this is just one of many examples of the wonderful programs that the ARI is doing. Let me just mention that ARI isn't the only ones doing Asian American events. This coming Monday here at the Graduate Center at Ellie Bash Recital Hall, we're having a play by a Queens College professor, Ira Hartman, about a mathematician, an Indian mathematician named Ramanujan, who went to England early in the century, being born in a very small town in India, all by himself, and now coming to the big city of London and doing mathematics with Hardy. And it deals with the relationship of him trying to integrate within the Eastern and Western worlds that he was now living in. So a lot is going on. We're very pleased that you're here. Welcome and enjoy the show, as they say.
Thank you, Brian. Okay. Before we actually get started, I want to also acknowledge a few other people here. Of course, none other than Dr. Thomas Tam, who is back there holding up the wall. Just give a hand to him. And a couple of other folks. I'm not sure if everyone's here, but part of the judges panel, the responsibility was to go through a lot of the films and make decisions about the films. And we have a few of them here. Daryl Chin is over there. Daryl, raise your hand. Is Yuan Hong here? There she is. There she is. Ying Zhu, is she here? No? Okay. And Ropali Mahirji was also part of the panel. But also, I'd like to recognize the staff that really helped put this together, particularly Nong Tran, who's out there manning the table, as well as Anthony Wong, Philip Lee, and Nick Feng as well. So they're the ones who really brought it all together, so I think we should give them a hand as well. I was asked earlier by somebody, you know, why a CUNY Asian American Film and Media Festival? And, you know, just from a personal perspective, as a product of Asian culture, I certainly abide by that long-abide tradition in Asian families to respect and honor and listen to your elders. And, you know, certainly as the father of three children, I think it's a hell of a good idea. But as a filmmaker and educator, I'm also happy to be part of a process that really trying to undermine the idea in Asian American families that to pursue a career in media arts is tantamount to treason, right? So I really look forward to a day where more and more Asian parents will no longer have that look of bewilderment or disappointment when they say, "Mama, Papa, I'm going to major in film and video." So on a very basic level, the reason for having an Asian American Film Festival is simply to find a sense of camaraderie among the Asian American film and media students here at the various campuses of the CUNY system, and to show their work. On another level, the idea of an Asian American festival really speaks to a larger question. Is there a particular Asian aesthetic to these works? What binds us as Asians? You know, is it the food? Is it the way we look? Is it language? Is there some sort of shared experience among the different groups that identify themselves as being Asian or Asian American or Pacific Islanders? I'll certainly let other people who are smarter than me debate and discuss this topic. But you know, the one thing I do know is that we all have an innate need to express ourselves, to really tell the stories that wanting to share the kind of the hopes and the desires and the fears that we have in our lives. Because it really wasn't too long ago that images of Asians in American cinema were nothing more than stereotypes of a demured or exotic dragon queen like Susie Wong, or perhaps a heartless and cruel Japanese soldier, usually played by the Chinese actor Ki Luke, or the inscrutable and sly detective of a Charlie Chan, who wasn't even Asian and kind of talked like a walking fortune cookie. Well, the list certainly is long, but the one thing they all had in common was their representation of people that seemed to be monolithic and kind of one-dimensional, and at its worst, inhuman. They weren't even images that were conceived or made by the people they were supposed to represent. And we have films like The Good Earth, which really, at its worst, after all its good intentions, ultimately a pretty Well, let's just say it's an interesting film, for those who know about that film. But as with any culture or group of people, when we really lose the capacity to tell our own stories or to imagine our own images, we really no longer have the ability to dream. And of course, without our dreams, there's no future. But tonight, we're going to see that the Asian American experience is really a rich, a very deep and a varied, as reflected in the really wonderful films that are being made by our City University of New York students. I really hope that you enjoy them and discover that the Asian American experience is more than just a fortune cookie. So with that, I'd like to introduce Wellington Chan. So here we go. Wellington.
Thank you, Professor Liu. Good evening, everyone. I'm delighted to be here to represent Chancellor Matthew Goldsmith. And thank you, Brian, for letting me use the space. What stands between you and the exciting films is my long speech, and so therefore I'm going to keep it extremely short. I must commend Dr. Tam for organizing this festival and this event, because he does fabulous jobs. Dr. Tam is also, for those of you who don't know, you probably all know by now, he's also a filmmaker, along with my brother who's sitting in the audience, Joseph Chan over there. He's also a CUNY graduate of Picker Film Institute. For those of you who don't know, Picker Film Institute was at one time, I think it still is, more selective than the NYU Film School. It's very, very picky, and that's why it's hence not the way Picker is named, but it is a very selective school, so I want you to know that that program exists. But as Professor Liu alluded to earlier, there is a great deal of misconception about what Asian is, and I think it really transcends all the boundaries about, it comes down to basically our core as human beings. And I think, you know, all you have to do is just look at the images from Iraq. You know, how one day an image flashed across the screen changes your perception about what the war is all about, or what the campaign is all about. You know, from toppling of the statue by an Asian soldier to topple the statue of Saddam Hussein. And next day you have an image, a year later you have an image of the prison scandal. And so I think that, you know, the one thing I did learn, because I started looking at my brother's film early on when he was still in school, is that there is a great deal, even where you just position the camera, makes a statement. So I hope you enjoyed it, because I never knew that. I said, I place a camera, that's the angle. But what you learn is that even where you place the camera says something about, you know, I'm preaching to the choir for those of you that are filmmakers here. But I think it's so important that the core essence is about understanding one another, and the idea that we have this misperception. And the better communication, the more communication we have, the better it is. So I hope you enjoy the film tonight. I can't wait to see, but unfortunately, this is also a big night for Dr. Tam's daughter's wedding. So unfortunately, I had to leave, even though I want to see all these great products. So have fun tonight, and keep up the good work. Thank you.
Thank you. Oh, you know, she's stable. Oh, yeah. Okay. Well, we do things a little bit different here. You know, usually you give out awards at the end of the film festival, but we're going to do it differently here. We're going to give out awards at the beginning. So with the help of Brian and Wellington, we're going to hand out the awards. So the award for runner-up prize in the open competition film category goes to Yan Lin for Learning Chinese, The Story of Ting He. For personal category goes to Min-Kyu Choi for The Theory of Pleasurable Constipation. Okay, here we go. We're moving right along. The award for runner-up prize in documentary goes to Anna Raquel for Kaduma. Okay. Okay. This is going by pretty fast, huh? Yeah, it's okay. You want to switch? Okay, he's going to do more. You're going to, about 20. No, I'm just kidding. No. Okay, the first prize award in the open competition film category goes to Rioma Kam for No Light, Big City. Okay, and here's the biggies. The first prize award in the personal category goes to Mutsumi Onuma for The Penny. She brought her own cheering section. The first prize winner in the documentary category goes to Shalini Kataya for Matan the Churning. And we're going to take a photo all together. You know, awards are awards, and I really actually want to acknowledge all the filmmakers, all the students who submitted work. It is not an easy road, certainly for those who are uninitiated in the process to make a film or a video. And I would like to have everybody give a round of applause for all the students here. Okay, enough talk. Let's look, let's watch, and enjoy the program. If people have questions or just to recognize them once again for all of their hard work. So if the filmmakers, if you're still here, you can come on up. Yeah. Don't be shy. All right, we have some. Some of them are still awake. All right, very good. Does anybody have any questions for our filmmakers tonight? Yeah, we have. There we go. We have a lot of ones.
I have a question for the filmmaker. You spoke, you know, in the piece, you talked about the journey of many of the people that you met. What was your own journey of when you stayed there and throughout the...
Just briefly, he's a plant, by the way. I spent 2 months living at the banks of the Ganga during this festival and shooting with 70 million people around, and it was a little bit tricky. And just going out with my camera, and I had a crew, two other guys that I was sharing a tent with, and we just used to go out and shoot, and it was so overwhelming. The festival itself was so overwhelming visually. It was very hard to figure out where to put your camera and it was interesting. And, you know, there was just so much information. So, but it was a really beautiful experience, and I actually did have a bath for many, and I was moved by the festival.
This is a question actually for all the filmmakers. I was just wondering what were like the difficulties you guys had in making your film, and if you could also tell us any future projects that you're working on.
Let me start down this way. Yeah, let you start.
See difficulties.
you only have 3 hours.
Okay, I'm sorry. My espresso wore off, so. I guess my main idea of like doing something relating to indigenous people in Philippines, where I'm physically here in New York City, and you know my subject matter is there. So I guess I found a focal point with poetry, Rakanais, who's the woman in the film. And with her experiences, I was able to bring it together. And I guess her being there helped me a lot, really, you know, giving us a solidity to the problem.
My problem, and making a film, especially here, the main problem is language and money. I hope it will be better. The situation will be better after finishing my study. But it's a good process and very interesting process, so I enjoy it. I'm hoping enjoying it.
For me, the kind of same problem happened. I didn't have enough money, and I didn't have enough food, so I and my DP struggled how to shoot my teeth, and I came here 1 year, and the new people were so poor. So we got problematic, and that couldn't stay outside, but and the snow from Padma. And we couldn't continue the shooting. We couldn't continue shooting. But yeah, in a, it was very good exercise and it was very good study for me. I never been worked in a such small group, but so it was very valuable. But so we learned a lot during choosing, so it was very pleasure.
My involvement with the filmmaking was an accident. I was a volunteer at community organization. ISS, Immigrant Social Services. And basically I just found out that there was a class which was learning how to do digital video making, and I just said, okay, let me try it. So we had a blackout and we went out and tried different things and filmed all the personalities around town. And we actually had some problems with just the basics, you know, simple things, technical, you know, like the sound, you know, shooting the person, whether or not, you know, you're moving too much or the camera moving around, because we were amateurs. Actually, the film really should be credit to other person who couldn't show up today, Lindsay Cole and Julia Chan, and also Immigrant Social Services, directors over there, actually, for them.
See, I helped us a lot. Please stand.
But he really helped us a lot. And my next project is trying to film a southwestern China, the rural development and the indigenous people there, the male group. Really try to film about this organization, started by this one woman in America who is really funding the education of young children and orphan children in China. So hopefully that I can finish that up next year.
How about the rest of you? What are you guys working on?
I finished my project. It's about, it's a documentary about Dong. But Power of Dong, the peasant, Power of Dong, the main.
You have an obsession with that, right?
Thematically, it's a one-hour documentary. It's more
What are you working on next?
Right now, I'm working for
I started filming the Malapena Tuban actors who used to live around the volcano that erupted in 1999. And I started filming them in December. Hopefully it'll be an ongoing process. related to the culture and the struggles.
Yeah, my next film is actually on fiction, and this film about this river got me interested in water, and I found out this alarming statistic that by the year 2027, two-thirds of the earth is not going to have drinkable water accessible. So my film is a futuristic fiction film based on water shortage in the year 2027.
Great. Do you have any questions?
I just want to follow up on you. You just said that you've been working on film and water. Are you aware that I'm sure you know the book Water Wars?
Yes. I've actually met the author.
I think she was in your film, right?
No, that was Vandana Shiva. The woman who wrote that is actually Maude Barlow. It's a great book called... Oh, Vandana. Yeah, that is Water Wars. She did write that book. It's a great book. I think it's
okay. Well, I also want to apologize to some of the filmmakers for some of the technical problems. This is the first CUNY Asian American Film Festival, so we learned a lot, and I'm sure the second one is going to be a lot better. And certainly, I want to thank everyone who came out to support the students who make these wonderful, wonderful works. So, thank you.